tearing out pieces of me to replace the broken pieces of you. Hello, wealthy family, and welcome to today's Mindset Monday. Thank you for coming and sharing some time with me. This is the last Mindset Monday of 2021. Can you believe it? Y'all been rocking out with me for a whole entire year. And may I just say that today, December 27th, I'm so thankful for all of you. I'm about to hit 600 subscribers, and it was just my birthday. I was trying to hit 222. I didn't hit 222 subscribers until after Pisces season, and here I am about to hit 600. So thank you all. I love you all. I just wanted to share that tidbit with you. But today we're going to talk about how to get your mind prepared for the new year. Okay, sometimes people for the new year, they can start to panic, they can start to feel a little depressed. They can start to feel a little anxious about what to come, what didn't happen. They may have great anticipation because they had a great year, or they could have, again, great anxiety because the year wasn't so great. But regardless of how your year went, it is not meant to, you should not rather be looking at the new year like a, you know, new year, new me. I can get this done. Oh, I'm going to leave all this in the past. Yes, that's true. And yes, that's accurate. However, you can do that anytime. Okay. You can do that anytime. So don't allow yourself to get caught too much into the hype. All right. When we start off the new year in January, we will be, I'm sorry, y'all. We will be starting off in Venus in retrograde, and then about 2 weeks in, Mercury's going retrograde January 14th, okay? A lot of communication, relationship evaluations. If you have anything electronic, make sure you back it up. If you have anything coming up court, make sure you, you know, be mindful of that. Reschedule if you can. Elective surgeries, I wouldn't stick around with that. And it's that energy until about February 3rd, okay? So it's not a doom and a gloom. It's just be careful. Be mindful, right? Right at the beginning of the year. That's right around the time also when people are starting to shag off their resolutions because they may feel it's too hard, or they may feel disappointment because they're not seeing the quick results that they want, okay? It's not a time for microwave mentality as well. That's why I tell people don't make resolutions, but make a decision, okay? Be decisive in your actions. When you make resolutions, the energy behind it is automatic. It's meant to be broken. I can switch this up, right? When you make a decision, it's concrete, it's firm, it's solid, okay? So make up your mind to make a decision. Also, in preparation for the new year, don't wait until January 1st. Do this now, okay? Do it now. Whatever it is you want to start doing, do it now, because you got to create the habit now. Remember, it takes 21 days to create a new habit, forming new pathways for your mind, and 90 days to create a new lifestyle, all right? National Quitters Day, I think is January 10th or January 14th, or somewhere around there is National Quitters Day, where people quit and give up on their resolution, and they try to make it a lighthearted thing, but that's really disparaging to know that there's a National Quitters Day, all right? So don't fall victim to that. Don't get sucked into that hype, all right? Make a vision board. Create your vision now for the new year, okay? Break down your year how you want it to be, all right? Astrologically, the year doesn't start until the springtime. So technically, things that you do January, February may not turn out the way you want them to, okay? So start bringing it down by the seasons, right? Go with the spring. Spring, you want to do this. You want to see this happen. Summer, you want to make this goal, right? Maybe you want to take a trip that's at least 50 miles outside of your hometown, for those who may not travel often, okay? Autumn time, you wanna make a decision that you're going to go help and volunteer more, all right? The winter time, you may make a decision that you're going to put yourself first instead of falling into the commercialized idea of giving to others, right? Just different little things. And I spoke about this on my podcast today as well. If you didn't catch me, you can catch the replay on TuneIn Radio, Apple, Spotify, wherever you catch your podcast at. I'll probably put the link down below in the description. But I spoke about this because A lot of people go in with this, I'm just gonna eat this dozen donuts and I'm gonna do better next month, okay? Or in prep for the new year, I'm just gonna go ahead and chug this gallon of vodka and it'll get better, right? I promise I'm not gonna drink anymore, okay? They use this as in a time for excuses for bad behaviors and bad habits and then brush it off thinking that they'll be able to change it in the blink of an eye. And that's not the way it works, okay? So make a decision that you're not gonna wait until the new year to do things, but you're gonna start to do it now, immediately, okay? I'm sorry I'm so fidgety today. I'm sorry. But make a decision that you're gonna do it now, okay? That you're gonna get things done now, immediately, quick, fast, in a hurry. Another way to prepare your mindset for the new year is not looking at it like it's a brand new year. Every single day is a new day to clean your slate. Every single day is a new day for you to start fresh and start new. So make a decision that you're going to live that way, and you're going to look at the new year as just a change in the numbers, just a change in the cycles, right? Look at life as a cycle and not as a time warp, okay? Don't let yourself get stuck in that loop. Sometimes people look and they're like, man, time is flying. It's going by so fast. I've wasted so much time. I've done this. I've done that. X, Y, Z, A, B, C, whatever. And it causes them stress. Look at it like a cycle or like a season, okay? Follow the seasons of Mother Earth. Mother Earth is not keeping a calendar, okay? The universe is not keeping a calendar. Yes, the numbers are important. Yes, time is important. But follow the natural calendar, which is the seasons, and go with that flow. Make a decision that you're going to do that, okay? Also, try writing a letter to yourself of how you want the year to go. Or you can, again, break it down by quarters, right? So the first quarter, this is what I would like to see. This is what I like to work on. And make sure that you keep them small. Small, attainable things that you want to bring into your life. Do not put things so high up and astrological where it seems so far out of reach, and then when you don't hit it, now you feel discouraged. If you've never made more than $50,000 in your life, do not sit there and say, I'm going to become a millionaire. Is it possible? Yes. But will your mind allow you to really stretch that far and reach it? Probably not. A better goal would be, you know what? I made $50,000 this year. I'm going to reach to make $150,000, right? That's a big stretch, right? That's a big vision for you. And it may seem out of reach, but it is within grasp to go from 50,000 to 150,000. I know, okay? Ask me how I know. I've lived it. You can do it. But that's the trick to hitting things and attaining goals and crushing them and not getting discouraged and give up. Okay, if you know that you love sweets, me, do not make a resolution to cut all sugar out and say, you know what, I'm only going to use agave and Splenda. That's not going to work. Within 2 weeks, you're going to be so freaking miserable, you're going to quit. Make a decision that you're no longer going to eat packaged sweets. That's what I did. Now, I can't, well, it may be the baby, but I can't even eat Little Debbie. I used to love zebra snack cakes. And the other day, I was like, I want some zebra snack cakes. I haven't had it in like a year. I haven't had any zebra snack cakes. And I bought some and ate some and I threw it right up. It tasted different to me, right? But I still take 4 teaspoons of sugar in my tea. Right, I still like when my son makes brownies, I will eat a quarter of the pan. Okay, I still like my Rita's Italian ice. Okay, I know I'm not gonna cut sugar out because I enjoy it. I know I'm gonna eat my gummy bears. I know I am. Okay, but certain sugars I've been able to cut out my life because I made a conscious decision. I no longer wanted to eat those empty things. That's how you should move, okay? If you know that you don't drink enough water, make a decision that you're going to up your water intake by 50%. So that means if you only drink one bottle, then you're going to go to 2 bottles a day, right? If you only drink a quarter, you know, like 16 cups, say I'm going to drink 32 cups of water, right? I'm going to make it a goal. I'm going to make it a decision, right? And that way, when you fulfill those little things to yourself, you feel so much better, all right? It's just a matter of shifting your mindset. Do not let this new year get you down, and do not anticipate too much, because when you anticipate a lot, right, when you go into something with high expectations, and I'm not saying don't anticipate things or don't look forward to things and don't be encouraged for certain things. I'm just saying when you hype things up too much and you put the goal so far ahead and you don't hit it, it can be discouraging. And then you get down in the dumps and you're like, nothing ever works out for me. How dare I even dream? That's why I'm not optimistic. XYZ, yada, 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 right? You heard this story before. So those are just some tips on how to get yourself prepared for the new year. Make sure that you are safe. Make sure that you enjoy yourself. Do enjoy yourself. Even though astrologically the new year doesn't start until the spring, people are still out here celebrating. You can use the momentum of the new year. You can use the momentum of January to help usher in new things, okay? Go into a meditative state. My family and I have a New Year's Day tradition that I look forward to every single year that we will be implementing, right? So get out and do what it is that you love. That's the most important thing. Right? Make a decision that you're going to do more of what you love. Don't let these things, these lockdowns and these people ramping certain things up, scare you back into a hole. Please, for the love of God, do not do that. Okay? At the end of it all, just make sure you don't do that. Okay? Find something to celebrate and celebrate it. I don't care how big or how small it is. All right? Okay, wealthy family, that's all that I have for you today. I love you all. I appreciate you all. And until we connect again, stay alert, stay aware, and live in love. Peace.